I can say to you that is so essential and important if your child has recently been diagnosed is to get your child healthy as possible. And there are lots of different things that you can do, and it's going to be different for every single child. So I really want to appeal to your parental instincts and tell you to find a pediatrician who is going to be able to address your concerns. If you find that when you go into your pediatrician that they're poo-pooing everything, if you met with some resistance as you were getting your child diagnosed, we had had to change our pediatrician, and had only been with our pediatrician a couple of months when we first started to see the first symptoms of autism. And I remember saying to that pediatrician at the time, I'm concerned, because he had been speaking in full sentence and now he's not. And the pediatrician said to me, oh, it's fine. Just wait until he turns two and he'll be talking in paragraphs. I've seen this time and time again. Yes. Would I like to go back and kick her now? Now, was she doing the best job that she could? Absolutely. But I think that any time a pediatrician, and we did, once he was diagnosed, we immediately switched again, because I needed to be with somebody that I could have a fresh start with, and somebody that wouldn't poo-poo when I was saying things. And that's just so essential that you be heard. We're with our kids more than anybody else. We need our pediatricians. We cannot do this alone. We need our doctors, and in some cases we need specialists to work with our kids. But we need for them to hear us. We need for them to listen to us and to respond to what we ask them. And we need for them to ask us questions, and most essentially, we need to be able to ask them questions, as many questions as it takes. Trust me, I ask more questions than anybody I know. I can be so irritating, because not only will I ask the question, but then I'm like, okay, so what I just heard you say was this. Is that what that means? Because this is my child. And, you know, it's there is that little part of me that feels, that still is working out the fact that I dropped the ball a little bit because I didn't listen to my instinct. I went to the pediatrician and I said, I'm concerned. I feel like something's up. She said, oh, no. And I decided to listen to her more than to my gut. And I would encourage you to keep looking for a pediatrician until you find somebody who listens to you. You always want to feel listened to. So, and if your child needs something more, to seek out the specialists who can help your child. Our children, the other day I went through at length the diagnosis and all the things that are included in the diagnosis, but there's a whole bunch of things that well-meaning pediatricians and emergency room doctors and other doctors will lump in and say, oh, well, you know, that's the autism, when it isn't. If your child is having other issues, you need to find somebody who looks at your child as a whole child. Our children have medical issues besides autism. Right? You know, nowhere on the autism spectrum does it say, oh, and by the way, you will have a cut on your foot, right? And so if you went to a doctor and said, my child has a cut on the foot, and the doctor said, oh, well, that's all part of the autism diagnosis, you would think that they were a little crackers. I don't know. So apply that to other things. If your child is having medical issues, you need to find specialists who will address your child's individual needs. And that's a really important thing, so that they don't just get included in this, oh, autism umbrella, which a lot of doctors will assume with our children. So I can't say that enough, that it's so important that our children are healthy. If I were to ask you to do something really important in your life and to take a class that was going to give you safety information about your home and your life and your kids, I would not want you to come to it with all kinds of medical issues that made it harder for you to concentrate. I would want you to come to it as healthy as possible. And when we start ABA, we know that we're giving our children skills for a lifetime, skills to help them to be able to communicate, to be able to be friends with other people, to be able to play, to be able to learn. And we definitely want them to be healthy when they are learning from us.